maybe two, and I had Hamadashi later. And there were surprise, and it was awesome. It was on Friday night, and then we took it the next year out of the temple, once we didn't have the building anymore. And we took it to the Brooklyn Park Conservatory, this beautiful setting, and it just wasn't big enough. On Friday night, we packed the house, and we had awesome Shabbat service. And then we ended up, hi Modi, hi Kat. And then we ended up, just, you know, you can't stop me.
Port and Hamantash goes back to my great-great-grandmother in Poland in the late 1800s. And that recipe was handed down to my grandmother and to my mother. And the tradition in our family was you get together with your kids and you bake and friends. And so Allie used to tell me when she was here, she says, Dad, nobody really bakes Hamantash. And she says, I got to get all my girlfriends involved in this. So she'd have all her friends come over and the kids would come over. And it was something that they started doing and everybody enjoyed. Because you know, it's such a great family community. Allie's a very traditional Jewish woman. She was a very traditional Jewish woman. So it's important for me to continue her legacy. Her three children, Reese, Blake, and Jordan, they live here. They will grow up here. They've gone to the GCC and different schoolings. And, you know, my goal with the Allison Center Hamantashen Festival through Temple Israel is that when my oldest granddaughter, who's now 8, I would like in 10 years for her to take this over and to be the chairperson of it. And then she can do it with her sisters. And it's a great way for not just the three girls, but the whole community to stay connected to a woman who really expressed, she was the epitome of, you know, tradition and sharing and, you know, religion. She had such Judaism inside of her.